I left the capital of Andorra, Andorra La Vella, by going north, turned west on a road CG4 to start a very scenic climb up to 2,300 meters altitude, where the tarmac road ended and turned into a gravel road at Col de Cabus.
All aboard!
The pass is also the borderline between Andorra and Spain, and it is the starting point of a trail I've been looking forward to ride for a long time. It's well known among adventure riders. It's called the Smugglers Route or Smugglers Trail. You can find and download the track on TET Spain. The trail had its peak traffic in the 80s, and the main goods transported was tobacco products, smuggled from the tax-free haven of Andorra into Spain. There is still no border control or checkpoint at the point, and the train is probably still used for the same reason as in the 80s.
The old smuggler road, here we go.
The weather report for today wasn't the best, but no way I would take an alternative route just because of some rain. The Smugglers Trail was today's highlight, even if I knew the rest of the day would offer some great Pyrenees rock and roll roads. A good gravel trail is a good gravel trail, also when you're riding a fully loaded fat lady. She's amazingly capable and agile despite all the kilos, and my poor off-road tires. The trail is rocky, with ruts from pouring rainwater, and could be a little bit slippery when wet, as the lady said, but it is a rather easy ride. Just take it cool and enjoy the magnificent views. They just keep coming. Heights are not the best friends, and there are a lot of free falls at the sides of the trail. My vertigo made me clung to the inside most of the time. But if I could do it without shitting my pants, everybody could do it.
inside. Hola. Hola.
This is the famous water crossing you've probably seen on many dramatic pictures. It's just a little stream to cross without any drama. A little water splash is always fun, but you don't have to worry about drowning your engine. Just go. Roadblock ahead. No signs about this coming from Andorra. Well, let's open the door and continue. If the track is washed away, I will turn, but not for a little string across the trail. top of the pass.
Really can hear this thing.
Luckily for the group of Portuguese riders, I had a pump, so they could fix the flat tire of one of the bikes and continue their journey. After a wet stop, I joined them, and we eventually became good friends. More on that topic in my coming videos. Thanks for the excellent two-course dinner, Manuel. Hope to see you soon.